Hey y'all, welcome back. Mandy with My Hectic Life Pets, where we talk about all things pet and pet related. And today, amongst all the hornworms, I found something special. So I actually found a pupa in amongst the hornworms. Now, interesting thing about these guys is that they tend to burrow under the substrate and form into a pupa instead of like many other moths and butterflies, where they will form a cocoon as they turn into a pupa. So I thought it would be fun. I decided to bring it home, and so I guess I have a new pet. So this guy, if I understand correctly, these guys will turn into a sphinx moth. So if I understand everything correctly and I've done my homework well enough, these guys are the tobacco hornworm, and they will burrow into the substrate and turn into the pupa stage and emerge from the substrate as a very large moth, which is where they got the nickname, the Sphinx Moth. Now I am very, very interested in seeing how this guy is going to turn out, and I'm going to have to get him a relatively large habitat and setup. Then if everything goes well, then I will be updating y'all in the future on what happens with this moth. I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to find a screened cage large enough for him. I might end up having to get a chameleon tank or something. These guys can have up to a 4-inch wingspan. So depending on how big he is, they need to be able to fly in order to feed, so they have to have enough room to be able to fly in. If you keep them in a smaller habitat, then you will have to hand feed them, which can be really time consuming, and I personally don't want to spend 45 minutes to an hour a day feeding my moth. So basically, for right now, as a temporary habitat, I'm going to set up a mason jar and put some eco earth along with a little bit of moss to put the pupa in and moisten it, because they need a moist substrate to be able to morph into their full moth state. So this is going to be kind of an interesting experiment that I am really excited to see how everything turns out, and I hope that it will emerge as a beautiful large moth and that I will have a new kind of different pet. So I know a lot of classrooms will try this type of experiment where they will have a bunch of horned worms and let the kids kind of see the different stages of life for these caterpillars turning into their cocoons, or turning just straight into pupa and then turning into moths or butterflies. And I think it'll be fun for my kid to see this pupa turn into a large moth. And it'll be, like I said, a really kind of fun, interesting little pet to have, even if it will be probably for a short period of time, since they don't really have a very long lifespan. So how many out there have done this type of experiment where you've tried to raise a caterpillar into a butterfly or a moth? Post your experiences in the comments below. I would love to hear all about your experience with this process and how things went, and if you kept it as a pet for a while, or if you tried it again. So that's all for today's video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, where I post new videos every week. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye!